Morning students, so the next topic is features of a harbor, and the features of a harbor are entrance channel, berthing and turning basin, breakwater, pierhead, wharves and jetties. So we can discuss one by one. So this is the figure showing different parts of a harbor. This breakwater, jetty, entrance channel, this is the anchorage area, turning basin, ships are parked here, and port facilities. Okay, so entrance channel, so depth and width are kept more at entrance because this width depends upon the density of traffic and number of entrances. That is, when width increases, more number of ships can enter through this area. So this entrance channel is the area through which ships are entering into the harbor. So its depth and width are kept more at the entrance. Next is berthing and turning basin. Okay, so this berthing and turning basin, this is the berthing and turning basin area, and this is used for parking ships. This area is used for parking ships. Berthing and turning basin. Next structure is breakwater. Okay, so we have discussed about breakwater. Breakwater are the structures which is constructed to enclose the harbors, and it will protect the harbor from the wind waves. Okay, so this this breakwater, it will be like a long wall having some height. Generally, the height of the breakwater is kept as equivalent to 1.2 to 1.25 times the waves expected. Okay, so this actually a long height wall which is used to prevent, which is used for protecting the harbor from the high wind waves, and also helps to prevent beach erosion. Okay, and the most common breakwater used has a core of small rocks or rubbles with covering large rocks to keep the core from being affected from the wind waves. Okay, so this breakwater helps to use the area thus enclosed as a safe anchorage for ships and to help the loading and unloading process. So that area is protected from the high wind by this breakwater. Okay, and the height of this breakwater depends upon its purpose, then extent of enclosed water area, and nature of existing shipping work. So this is a rubble mount breakwater. So for that we are using some rubbles, gravels, etc. Next feature is pierhead. So the structure provided at the tip of breakwater, such as lighthouse, that is known as pierhead. The structure provided at the tip, this is the breakwater, so at the tip of the breakwater we are providing this pierhead as a lighthouse, such as lighthouse. This is known as pierhead. Next is wharves. Wharves means the structure constructed parallel to the shore or breakwater. This is constructed parallel to the shore or breakwater, and it will be having a wide platform at the top. Okay, so it is actually constructed parallel to the shore or parallel to breakwater, and it will be having a wide platform at the top, and its function is to permit berthing of vessels alongside for cargo working. So that is the function of wharves. Next is jetties. So it is the narrow structure projecting from the shore into the water with berths one or both sides, and sometimes at the end also. So this is the jetties. It is a narrow structure projecting from the shore into the water, and these structures are in the form of pile projections and built from the shore to deep water. It is built from the shore to the deep water, and it may be constructed in the sea or in a navigable river. Okay, and the jetties extend from the shore to the deep sea to receive the ships. Okay, so it is extending from the shore to the deep sea in order to receive the ships, and it is somewhat same as our wharves, and it is used for loading and unloading of cargo, and it is made usually from shore towards the sea water to prevent silting and dredging to allow free flow of tidal currents. Okay, so these are some of the features of harbor. Next, requirements of a good harbor. Okay, there is a ship channel which may either be natural or artificial, must have a sufficient depth for the draft of vessels visiting the harbor. Okay, that is, it should have sufficient depth in order to receive the ships. That is one of the requirement of a good harbor, sufficient depth. And the bottom should furnish secured anchorage in order to hold the ships against the force of high wind. There will be always high wind velocity or wind waves. So in order to protect the ships, or in order to give a anchorage, or in order to hold the ship against these high wind waves, there should be secured anchorage. Okay, so for that the bottom should furnish. So there should be a strong anchorage in order to hold the ship against high wind velocity. That is the second requirement. And the land masses or breakwaters must be provided to protect against the destructive wave action. That is, there should be some landmass or breakwaters in order to protect the harbor from the high wave action, high wind wave action. That is the third requirement. And the harbor entrance should be wide enough to permit ready passage for shipping, and at the same time it should be narrow enough to restrict the transmission of excessive amount of wave energy during the storm. So that is another requirement. That is, the entrance should be wide in order to have ready passage for the shipping, and at the same time it should be narrow. That is, the width should not be very high, because if it is very high, there will be transmission of excessive amount of wave energy during storm. So it should be narrow also in order to prevent the excessive amount of wave energy during stormy weather. So that is another requirement. Next, it should be capable of easy, smooth and economic development. There should be a land area which is to be provided in order to have economic development in the future also. So it should be capable of easy, smooth and economic development. And last requirement, it should provide the maximum facilities to all the visiting ships, including the servicing of ships. There should be all the facilities for the ships. Okay, visiting ships, including servicing of ships. So all the facilities should be provided on this harbor. So these are the requirements of a good harbor. Okay. So next, about tides and waves, so I will put in the next class.